one of the cuts I made you sit through was probably 3 hours long. Hi, my name is Sam Fader, and I'm the director and co-producer of Disclosure.
My name is Laverne Cox. I'm the executive producer of Disclosure, and here's what was left on the cutting room floor.
The more you see trans people being supported and loved in film and television, you know, the more it will endear you to make sure that the trans people in your life, you know, are supported and loved and uplifted to affirm their humanity.
There's so many amazing things that I'm devastated that are not in the final cut of Disclosure.
You know, we were able to trim a lot of scenes down, but some scenes would really lose the impact by trimming them down. And this one scene comes to mind that we had to get rid of entirely, where we looked at 3-episode arc in All in the Family.
I feel like I have to say that Norman Lear did such and continues to do such groundbreaking television.
And he tackled a number of progressive issues on his show, including sexual orientation and gender.
There's a character named Beverly LaSalle, who Archie Bunker meets in his taxi. She's choking and Archie gives her mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
Oh, I'm Beverly LaSalle. Is your husband home? Mr. Bunker saved my life this morning.
You're the one. Well, come on in.
Beverly was in Archie's cab and choked or something, and he gave her mouth-to-mouth resuscitation, and then she comes to thank him.
Are you in show business?
Yes. I'm a female impersonator.
She says Mr., and she identifies as a female impersonator. She identifies that her profession is as such.
And Edith doesn't actually understand what that means.
Who can imitate a female better than a lady?
And Archie comes out, and they talk. And then just in this really kind of weird moment.
Why don't you call me Mr.?
The sort of trope of the wig coming off for their big reveal and then the vociferous laughter from the audience was one way that sort of folks disclosed, at least in films. I don't know if that ever happens in real life. You never know. Life is strange.
You never know.
Maybe that has happened in real life somewhere. But it's definitely happened a lot on camera.
That moment to disclose who she really is in that context was meant to be a joke, and it was also meant to shock Archie. And Archie Bunker was a bigot across the board.
The interesting thing about it, and Nick says this so beautifully, is that it feels like they kind of got, you know, trans women, drag queens, and female impersonators confused.
While typical of its time, I think that the show was a little confused about whether or not Beverly was a drag queen or a female impersonator or a trans woman. What really mattered was that she was a character audiences love.
To me, you're like a sister. No, I mean brother. Oh, well, both rolled into one.
What I loved about this clip is what Zachary Drucker said about it. And I know something's good when I am like, damn, why did I think of that?
It's ultimately about, does a trans person deserve to live?
Because there's a moment where Meathead says, would you have saved him if you knew that he was a guy? And that becomes the question, right?
Dumb question, of course I didn't know.
Yeah, but if you had known, what would you have done?
That's so troubling and so condescending to be like, this man is in a position where he's deciding if the trans person should live or die.
Yes, yes, all right, I would have saved the man, yes. Even if I'd have known he was a trans voice. But in that case, I would have blew into him through my hat.
But that a straight white man, cis white man, gets to be the arbiter of our existence just like stopped me in my tracks. And it was just like, whoa.
That layer that Zachary brought to it, and that's like this trans way of seeing that is really meaningful. We have all these sort of guttural reactions and we know something doesn't feel right, but sometimes we don't always have the framing. And that was one of those moments. It's like, I knew that the sort of conflation of transness and female impersonation and drag didn't feel right. And I knew the fact that she died didn't feel right.
Unfortunately, falling back into this trope of tragedy for trans characters.
I mean, everything was going so good for him and then somebody had to kill him.
Yeah, just because he was different.
Beverly is murdered in a mugging.
It's really sad when she dies, you know? Edith's performance is stunning and it's beautiful. But she dies.
She dies.
The way I feel today,
I may not go to church ever.
Even in a comedy.
You know, there were so many gems, so many beautiful stories. I mean, we collected, I think, over 600 television titles and over 400 film titles. There's so much material and so many voices and so many people that we weren't able to include. I would have loved to include more documentaries because in the same way that the talk shows and the reality TV are in constant dialogue with film and television, I think documentaries are as well. I think they all like give signals to each other of how to talk about trans lives. And as much as Hollywood has done a disservice, I think there are a lot of documentaries that have as well.
Just this idea of ethnography and this idea of like the filmmaker not having a perspective. Now we're critical of that, but I think for a really long time, people sort of assumed that like, you know, the documentarian could be sort of neutral. Now we understand that that's not a thing, really. But I think that the levels of exploitation, it's deep.
The way trans people have been represented on screen have suggested that we don't exist. And yet, here I am.
Disclosure is now on Netflix.